I hated that. Cards. There are four cards from each suit, diamonds, clubs, spades, and hearts. The cards are arranged in 4x4 grid as shown below, and four cards have already been put down. Range the remaining cards so each vertical column, horizontal row, and diagonal line contains one card from each suit. Tap a space to place a card there or change the card suit. So this spot has to be a club. Just because the conflicts in each of the other directions. Which means this one has to be a spade. This one has to be a heart because of conflicts in other directions with the fixed cards. That one has to be a spade there. Which would put the final spade here. So this could be a heart or a diamond at this location. Heart or diamond would be valid. This can't be a diamond, heart, or spade, so it has to be a club.
Should do the trick. And there we have it.
Okay.
This should do the trick. And there we have it.
Nice. No, there's lots of different puzzles.
This should do the trick. And there we have it.
Just leave it to me. Piece of cake.
It does do sort of groupings sometimes. Yeah, I'll take the pictures again.
And now to test my theory. And there we have it. And now to test my theory. And there we have it. consider this puzzle solved. And there we have it. This should do the trick.
I'm sorry? Are you sure?
Well, I suppose you can't win them all.
I, 1000% disagree. There's a shovel on one side and not on the other. Gotta point higher up on the shovel.
Maiden's apprentice strikes again.
The locked box. Two dials. You can't turn the blue dial, but when you turn the red dial, the blue dial moves an equal amount. See the relationship between the two dials? You turn the red one from its original position, as shown below. In order to open the lock, you must turn the blue dial to 3, 6, 4, and finally 1. So to get 3, you would input 2. To get 6, you would input 7. To get 4, you would input 1. And to get 1, you would input 4. 2, 7, 1, 4. I think that's correct.
And now to test my theory. Ha! Wonderful!
I didn't have to make a chart. I just realized it was symmetrical across, symmetrical across a certain line on the dial. The door says, "Hey bud, I'm not gonna open until you can solve this puzzle for me, eh?" The button that opens the door in front of you is buried deep within this machine, so you can't push it directly. However, by pulling the knob at the top, to the left or the right, you can move the various gears and plates in the machine, allowing you to press the button at the bottom. In order to open the button, should you pull the knob toward A or B? So I want the dial at the bottom to rotate clockwise. So that means the top of it needs to move right. Which means I need the gear right above it to turn counterclockwise. Which means the bar above it needs to move left. Which means that gear moves clockwise, counterclockwise, clockwise, right. So it's B.
Consider this puzzle solved. A true gentleman leaves no puzzle unsolved.
Why is it Canadian? Why would it not be Canadian? Y'all ask some silly questions. That was an S grunt tier comment. A maze of doors. All the doors in the maze below only open in one direction. Each door can be opened by pushing it from the direction shown below, but when approached from the opposite direction, no amount of pulling or pushing will open it. If you tried to go through the whole maze from start and passed through every room, you'd never make it to the exit. However, this feat would be possible if one of the doors could open in the opposite direction. Can you find and circle that door? I think it's this one. Oh, you need to be able to visit every single room? Okay. I think it's that one. You could go up, up, right, right, down, down, left. No, that still doesn't work. Right, up, left, right, right, down, down, left. Still think it's this one. You'd be able to go right, up, left, up, right, right, down, down, left, up, right, right, right.
Just leave it to me. That was almost too easy.
I don't think that Luke is a registered electrician. Licensed oh god damn it. Just fucking end my life already. I bet there is a way more efficient way to do this.
Here goes! Piece of cake!
In as few as 12 moves? Screw it. Do not care. The old safe. Find the 4-number code that opens the safe. You can use the numbers 0 through 5 in your answer, but each number can only be used once. Small lights next to each row of numbers are the key to finding the code, as they tell you how much in common that row has with the final code. Each white light indicates the number that matches one in the code, but it's in a different place. Orange lights is in the correct spot. Okay, so this is like, I'm halfway through a game of Mastermind. Got it. So the top row has all of the correct numbers. So any row, anytime I see the numbers 2 and 3, those are irrelevant. Orange means they're in the correct spot, so that means the first two are 0 and 1.
Consider this puzzle solved.
That was actually quite nice.
A true gentleman leaves no puzzle unsolved.
Yeah, I thought that puzzle was really clever. Really cool. Years ago. Wonder if he was using the box to transport some of whatever this thing is that's making people sick. That would explain someone dying from it. Luke did not decide to venture to Herzen Castle. The professor is forcing him. It's really sad if you think about it. God damn it.
This should do the trick. Well, I suppose you can't win them all.
Didn't hit the right button. I meant to hit my memo button. As you could see, I did not hit my memo button.
This should do the trick. A true gentleman leaves no puzzle unsolved.
You know, Layton, you could always just leave Luke down there. No one would ever know. No one would ever have to know. So what does it say? It says, heaviest ornament equals 3 of the lightest. And a medium is 2 of the lightest. The left hand side is currently heavier. So, these moons and this orb cancel each other out. I don't have to worry about the things in the very middle because they don't affect the balance. So I've got two stars, two orbs, and three moons. Seems to me like the moons are probably, or the stars are probably the heaviest. So I believe that to be the heaviest. So only one configuration is going to make sense. So this side is currently at 6 L. And this side is either, assuming that the orbs are the medium, then it's at, so if the orb is the medium, then the left-hand side is at 7. And if the moon is the medium, then it's at 8. So if the moon is the medium, then I would want to add one of the orb, And if the orb is the medium, I'd want to add one of the moon. No, wait. If the orb is the medium, then I'd want to add one of the moon. And if the moon is the medium, the orb is the medium, moon is the medium, then I'd want to add one of the moon as well. Okay, so in both cases, it actually turns out that it's the moon, I believe.
Consider this puzzle solved. Huh, wonderful.
Oh, he's been spying on me. Yeah, I think my logic was incorrect. Because what I needed to balance was the endmost pieces and the... I had to balance them separately, but I didn't, and it still worked out. So I lucked out on it. What's the punishment for a wrong answer? You just get fewer points for the solution. The left screen is the top one, yes. Use lamps to light up the dark forest paths. For each lamp, assume its light reaches to the end of any straight road. Use the fewest lamps possible to go through all the paths. I think that works.
This should do the trick. And there we have it.
Just leave it to me. Layton's apprentice strikes again.
Collect all the mushrooms in this forest as you pass through. Each circular clearing on the map contains mushrooms. You don't want to spend too long in this creepy forest though, so find the quickest route through that visits each clearing only once. Stay on the roadways. Well, you know, as a brain genius, traveling salesman problems really not an issue for me, you know?
Just leave it to me. That was almost too easy. Let's see if this works. That was almost too easy. Let's see if this works. Leighton's apprentice strikes again.
This should do the trick. A true gentleman leaves no puzzle unsolved.
Let's see if this works. That was almost too easy.
Hey, Pinchy. Six by six grid of sky and stars arranged into a larger to nine larger blocks. So that one has to go there. This one has to go here. Good.
Consider this puzzle solved. Ha! Huh, wonderful. Consider this puzzle solved. A true gentleman leaves no puzzle unsolved.
That one went well.
Just leave it to me. That was almost too easy.
A third one. Okay, now they're getting serious. Actually, I'm kind of curious what the hints would be, too. Alright, well, I'll take the hint, but I got no problem with looking at hints just to find out what they are.
Consider this puzzle solved. Ha! Wonderful!
The hamster sounds like the professor from The Simpsons.
This should do the trick.
Yeah, I guess so, impending disaster.
Leaves no puzzle unsolved.
Hmm. The end of the line.
Welcome.
Sorry to intrude, but we are investigating an important antique. This, the emblem on its lid seems connected to your house in some way. Would you have time to answer a few questions?
I think this matter would best be addressed by the master. Please, come inside.
Wow, this place is really something else.
Indeed, Luke. This castle is extremely impressive.
Professor Herschel Layton or Professor Herschel von Helsing?
Right this way, please.
Think about it, right?
Good evening. Welcome to my house.
So, okay. If I understand correctly, you're saying people fear the box because they...
See enough anime. This guy is either 12 years old or 8,000 years old.
That's quite a story, isn't it?
It seems that the design on this box is connected to your family in some way. Can you tell me anything about this?
It's true that it was a Herzen family heirloom. Although I parted with it a number of years ago, the garish emblem you mentioned wasn't exactly, suited to my taste.
Personally, I think it's quite spectacular.
Oh, is that so? Well, chalk it up to my bad taste then.
You know, I don't think he's telling us the whole story.
You think?
It's hard to say just yet.
I'm sorry I'm not much help, though I confess, visitors are always delightful.
I'm sorry, how old is Yami Yugi?
So please, do stay the night.
Because Yugi has a fucking deep voice when he's Yami Yugi.
Prepare the quarters for our guests, Nigel.
Yes, right away, Master.
Yes. Yeah, he's a fucking vampire, you morons. Here's an idea. Make him stand in front of a mirror. Easy. Thank you. I feel like it's something to do with whatever this frill is over here. Like we're seeing through a window, or we're seeing people standing on glass or something like that.
Let's see if this works. Well, I'm stumped.
Well, good thing we're not speedrunning it then. I mean, is it just the reflection down here?
Let's see if this works. Leighton's apprentice strikes again.
That really doesn't explain it, to be honest. Even if it was a reflection, it doesn't actually explain the perspective.
Is striking.
What are they doing together? Oh.
Fear not, my dear. They're just the main course for this evening. And my, don't they look fresh?
Okay, this game's a little too spooky for me.
It's been far too long since I've encountered prey so feisty.
And he'll say, I'm going to suck your blood unless you can solve this sliding tile puzzle.
Anton, what sort of madness is this?
I knew it! You are a vampire!
Well, if that's the case, it was rather foolish for you to venture here, wouldn't you say?
He's exactly right, honestly.
But I'm afraid it's too late now. I must begin preparations. In the meantime, why don't you just stay put and enjoy each other's company? After all, it'll be your last chance.
Layton's gonna be like, you know, this reminds me of a rather interesting puzzle. Okay, so this one doesn't matter. This one doesn't matter. I'm actually having a hard time following this one. This one's out. This one's in. And I'm pretty sure this one's in too. I actually think those are the only ones.
This should do the trick.
Remember when I said I thought that I was, you thought that I thought I was right? Eliminated. I don't think that anymore. Okay, so the inside is here. I just have to follow where the inside is of these ropes. I actually think this one might not be in. This one right here. I think that one might not be in. It might only be this one, actually.
And now to test my theory. A true gentleman leaves no puzzle unsolved.
Perfect. Time for me to search for hint coins. If you can solve this puzzle in 10 moves, you're worthy of love. God. I don't know why I'm having such a hard time with this. Do I want a hint? I mean, I could buy hints if I want hints. I just need to reverse the steps. I'm having a hard time remembering what the steps were. I'm rotating everything around. Or wait, no, I'm going clockwise. Okay. I don't know why I was having a hard time unrolling it.
And there we have it.
A new ore down the ground that Father thinks he can refine into a precious metal. Celebrate. At long last, the girl I love has agreed to give me her hand in marriage. I must begin preparing for her arrival at once. I'll gladly change out the castle's decor if it will make her feel more at ease here. I'm also commissioning a special dress to be made for her. She's going to look stunning in it, I just know it. All around town, people are falling ill to a disease that has no name. Some of the common folk have begun saying that our town has fallen under a curse. As the only son remaining to watch over Folsen's, I can't even think of leaving. The thought would be more disturbing were it not for her. As long as she's by my side, I have the strength to stay and protect this town. Oh, this wretched life of mine, the girl I loved and to whom I was betrothed has abandoned me and fled Folsen's. Did all that awful talk of curses scare her off, or did she truly leave me to be with someone else she loves? Either way, her betrayal cuts me to the core. I trusted her, and now I'm lost. Where do I go from here? What's left for me? Ever since she left, Father and I have been at each other's throats day and night. The mysterious disease plaguing our town continues to drive people to flee their homes for a safer life elsewhere. If only she had stayed with me, I feel like I could have weathered the storm. I still ask myself why she left this town. If she truly loved me, then why did she leave? My father fell ill from that sickness and has passed on. I also heard that many of the people who left Folsen's have formed a small village in a safe distance from town. I imagine she lives there now, too. I've decided to send her a letter. As Duke, I can't leave town, but I've entrusted my message with a man who's passing through town. Now all I can do is wait for her to reply. I don't know how many days I've passed with me waiting to hear back from her. It's been so long. In fact, even trying to figure out when I sent that letter has become difficult. Maybe she really doesn't love me. Maybe she's living in some other town, happily married to another man. Get together, dude.